Good day, Cass here, and today we're checking out the exploration and survival game Valheim, which you can now fully play in VR. The VR mod by Brandon Musso was out for a while, but you still had to use a keyboard and mouse, and in my opinion, that's not as immersive, but now full motion controller support is added, so we had to check it out. I'm excited to show you all the mechanics, but first, big thanks to the developers for providing us with a Valheim key. For those who don't know Valheim, well, this is originally a flat PC game for 1 to 10 players. It's set in a procedurally generated purgatory inspired by Viking culture. It's a world besieged by creatures of chaos and ancient enemies of the gods. It's up to you to battle, build, and get stronger to conquer the lands. What we love about the game are the very flexible house and base building system and the boss fights. So since this game is Cherry's latest addiction, I'll be playing with her in this video. She'll teach us the basics of the game, like crafting and building, all to get me ready for my very first boss battle. Cherry will be playing on a flat screen PC, and I'll play in VR to show you how all the VR mechanics work. And at the end, I will share a quick tutorial on how to install the mod yourself and my final thoughts. So the whole gameplay took about 4 hours, so I really did my best to cut it down as much as possible. I hope you have time to watch the full video as it's pretty exciting and it supports us. But if you want to skip through, timestamps are below. As always, please subscribe for more VR content, and now join me beyond reality right after a message from today's sponsor. Big thanks to Surfshark VPN for the continued support by sponsoring today's video. I'm a long-term user myself, as VPNs are necessary to keep your data private. A VPN encrypts whatever you send over the internet, so unauthorized people cannot eavesdrop on your traffic. But not only that, you can use it against geo-blocking too. For example, if you want to dive into Adventure Time, it's on Netflix, but not in every country. Surfshark can help with that. But I also like the competitive pricing, where one subscription allows you to use it on unlimited devices simultaneously. It's nice because you can protect all connected devices, like even your VR headset's data, if you put it on your router. If you use our link in the description and enter our promo code, you will get 83% off and 3 extra months for free. They also have a 30-day money-back guarantee policy, so if you don't like it, you can just cancel it. Welcome to Valheim in VR! As you can see, I am already in a pretty big base. Because this base is not mine. I am a newcomer in this game. Totally new, but Cherry has been playing this game for quite some time. So Cherry, where are you actually? Oh, I can see your name over there. So this is her base. Together. Hey. Well, you have been building this together with our mod, right? T-Stels?
Yes, I have been doing that.
Yeah, so you are the expert right here. So can you please show me the ropes of this game a little bit?
Oh yes, I will that. Today. I will do that for you, Cass.
So I'm not a completely newbie because we just practiced before a little bit and just checked it out. But I don't have a lot of stuff. I'm naked almost. I don't have shoes.
Oh my gosh, you don't have shoes. Yeah, first thing for survival in Valheim is like some building and food. So you need food to get more health and building to be able to craft stuff.
Oh, right.
So I think we need a workbench, and yeah, from there on we can go.
I think I should have some food already. I see my health is low. At bottom left, you can see your health in a really tiny little hot thing. The right controller touchpad opens the menu, and now I can see the menu. It's a little small, but I can walk a little bit towards the menu and kind of read a little bit better. Let me eat some cooked meat, and I also have berries over here. Okay, berries. I got them both.
Yeah.
And now I'm ready to go.
Come follow me.
Okay.
Let's go outside against some wood.
So before recording, we actually checked out some of the VR mechanics already. So I already know a little bit of the controls. I know that you need to press the trigger button, for example, to open the gates.
Oh, thank you.
Here we are. Now we need to chop some wood, right? On the index controllers at least, you need to press a B button on the right hand to get the axe out. And also on the B button on the left hand, you can get like, I don't know, shields and stuff. So as you can see, Cherry already gave me some gifts, which is really nice because I had nothing. And with this, I can chop trees, right?
Yes. So be careful with the trees because they can fall on your head and kill you.
Really? Is it falling already?
Oh, no, it's not.
No, it's not. No, it's not. So you can see it. Oh, it will roll down as well.
Yeah,
be
I see
careful.
It. So actually, I had to swing our arms in VR to do this. This is pretty cool. I always like doing that in VR, although it's pretty tiring, though.
Guys, behind you. Ooh. Behind you.
What? What's going on?
Don't you see the Graylin?
Yeah.
He's running away.
Why? Oh, he's coming back. Let's kill it. Is it dead? Oh, no, it's still alive.
It's still alive. Oh my gosh! It fell down, all the way down here.
Oh. Is the loot
You hit so hard, Kaz. That's okay.
Can I jump down?
Yeah, I think you can probably. Because with water you won't get...
My health! No! Fall damage. Okay, let me climb that up. So you can also jump. In VR.
Yeah.
Using you can jump the A button. Whee! Here we go.
You can also run.
Oh, jumping also uses stamina.
Yeah, everything uses stamina, what you do, that's not walking. So running, jumping. Actually, hitting also uses stamina. Dodging, rolling around. Everything.
I'm going to loot this wood. Give me the wood. Thank you. Oh, I'm swimming as well. Look at this.
Be careful, your stamina.
Oh yeah, my stamina is going down.
So swimming in this game... The only thing I don't know is why we cannot really dive. They definitely should add diving.
Well, I can kind of dive in VR right now. I can see
you
the
can
fish.
You can do that?
Yeah.
Yes, you can also fish. Actually, I have a fishing rod.
Really?
Actually.
Oh,
yes. Cool. Can you make it over here?
I got it. Oh, let's sit here for a sec and dry up. It's beautiful.
The tree of life.
I'm falling.
Did my butt kick you off? Oh my gosh, you're rude.
There's not enough space here for the two of us. Even though it's super romantic. Look at this. I mean, the game doesn't have like the best graphics ever. Well, it's still pretty beautiful. So building, I need like the hammer, right? You gave me this before. Okay.
Hammer.
And now there's a button, I think, for building. Yeah. B button. This is the building menu. So for the workbench, this is the workbench, I think. Yeah, here we go. I have the workbench. Okay, let me equip my shield because I don't know how to unequip my hammer without the shield. Here we go. Can I use it already? Crafting station needs a roof. Oh no.
Yes,
need a roof,
you need to build a roof around this thing. Otherwise you can't use it to build stuff.
Okay, so in VR to rotate, on the index, you need to touch the touchpad on the left controller. So you can rotate anywhere, which is pretty cool, actually. Look at this. Woo! Okay. Let me just build like this, I guess. What is the outside anyways? Or like this, maybe. Okay. Wait, let me move over here. Oh, no! Babe, doesn't look good. Is this going to be okay? There's a hole in my wall.
I've seen something prettier in my lifetime.
Can I do it like this? Is it not?
Is it
too low?
It's better. You should turn it the other way around so it goes up. And you can destroy stuff.
Oh, I think it's the A button. Oh, here we go.
Yes. Nice.
Why is it so hard to rotate? Oh, yeah, here we go. Oh my god. Okay, here we go. Is this good? Can I build already?
this one as well, yeah.
Okay, look.
No, it's too exposed. Oh my gosh, you do need to build around it.
Really?
Okay, wait, maybe it's because of this one. Maybe it's... Wait. I'm gonna help you because I'm a good girlfriend like that.
Did you just destroy my wall?
Oh my gosh, what the hell am I doing? No, my box! I didn't want to build that.
Can I destroy
one sec. Yeah, destroy it. It's okay.
I'm grabbing all the loot. Thank you.
Yeah, you need to build around it.
Really?
So to the left and... maybe here.
I'll do
over here.
Another wall. Is this going to work?
Yes, it works. Oh my gosh.
Seriously?
This is so pretty, Cass. It's so artistic. That actually did work, though.
What? How come there's a hole in there? I thought it snapped on. Oh. At least we get a nice view if you sleep here. Okay, so I can use it finally. Okay, workbench.
What do we want to make, by the way? Do we want to make clothing? Oh, maybe you can make clothing, actually.
Don't I have clothing?
No, you should, like, if you have nothing, you should look like this. You have, like, a shirt on and a pants now.
Oh, chair! Behave!
Yeah, hello.
What are you doing?
Your workbench is not the right level, but you can use mine.
I have nothing. Yeah, can you make it for me? Want. And then I will just try and make a spear, because I think you said before a spear was good, right?
Yeah, use a spear. Yeah, that's a good one. A spear is a good first weapon.
Okay, let me try and scroll this. It's really hard to scroll here in this in VR. That's one thing that we need to fix. This is the flint spear, but I need a lot of stuff. I need a lot of flint for this. I think I have 0, but I need 10.
Yeah, flint. Let's search for flint.
Flint is around the water, right?
Yeah, okay. Flint is around the water. Find. Let me see if you can find something, though.
Oh, what is this? Oh, a resin. What can you do with resin?
Resin is for fire, so like torches and stuff that need to give light.
Okay.
You can use that.
How come I don't see flint? Oh, there's one flint over here.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a boar over here. Shall we try and kill it with bow and arrow? Let me try. Okay. Yeah. Bow and arrow in VR is actually really cool. I can grab my arrows from my back, from my shoulder, and then you get like a helper line. Which I think, Cherry, you don't have a helper line, right?
I don't.
Without VR. Oh, look at that. I got him already. So
nice
cool.
Nice guess.
Let me grab the loot. So for the bow and arrow, by the way, to equip it, you have to actually go into the inventory and then also select the arrow, like the arrow you want to use. For example, I was using fire arrows, but if I want to use normal arrows, I have to pick those as well. And then, if I'm correct, yeah, I can pick them from my right shoulder. Look at this. I can shoot Cherry.
No, not shoot me.
Can I shoot that bird over there?
Yeah, you can shoot birds. Birdie. Yes, get it. You got. You need it actually for. Arrows.
Really?
Yeah.
Ooh. Here we go. Even got my arrow back, I think. Oh, wait.
Okay. No, you don't get your arrows back.
Oh.
That's the only thing I miss as well. You can also, like, sneak as well. Like, sneak attack.
Oh, right. Wait, sneak is, I think the joystick crouching. Down. Yeah.
Yeah.
So now I'm crouching with the right joystick down. And you can see the stamina is going down. And now I'm sneaking. And then, like, animals won't see you as fast, right?
Yeah, and you also do more damage if you do a sneak attack. So there's more flint over here, by the way.
Okay.
I don't know if you see it. Back. Oh, there's some more flint over here.
Oh my god, babe! Help me!
Do you really need my help, though? It's almost dead already.
Oh, that was cool. I got it.
Nice, nice. How much flint do you have, by the way?
I have 5 flint.
Okay. Yeah, we have enough, actually. I have 5 for you
enough.
As well.
Okay, can we please make the spear?
Yeah, let's go.
I can make it. Yes! I have a spear. Oh, look at that! Where's the head? Oh, over here. So I have to hold the spear, actually like this, it looked like, to attack. Interesting.
So here, let's go back to the house. It's dark now.
I don't have fire anymore in my... How do I make fire?
Yeah, you can put wood on your campfire thing. If you look at the campfire beneath, it says add wood.
Oh, okay. Adding wood to the fire.
Yeah, you did it.
Oh, yeah, I got it. Okay,
I'm gonna sleep as well.
Okay, sometimes after sleeping, it gets a little bit buggy with the VR mod. What you can do then is to recenter. So what I do is just put my hands in front of my headset for 3 seconds minimal, and it should like recenter for you, which is really helpful. I'm good again. I'm ready to go, Chair.
You want
to
make some food first? We can go here.
Yeah,
We can go to the house over there. Actually, the mod I'm playing with actually made this house. It's really nice.
Oh, whoa.
There you go.
Oh, that is beautiful.
I know.
Look at this.
You can cook your food over here.
Okay. So, I put my meat on there, right? Yeah, cook item, it says. I have meat.
Yeah.
Oh, I have meat. I have more meat than I thought. Oh, just 2 though.
I also need to make some in a bit. I'll wait until you're done.
I'm enjoying the fire while we wait.
I'm enjoying you.
Where are you?
While we wait.
Are you sitting on the
behind you?
Table?
Yes.
Aww. So cozy.
No, I know.
I wish I could sit.
So.
Oh, I can sit.
You can sit. You can sit?
Yeah.
Oh.
Wait, I need to check my meat.
If you don't grab your meat in time, it will become cold. And you can't eat it anymore.
I got it! What are we going to do?
Okay. We can actually look for like stronger enemies if you want. I can actually give you something. Okay, come here. I'm gonna give you some more protection because, you know.
Oh yes, please. Are we going to do a boss? Do you think we can do that?
I'm not sure if you can. You want to try?
Yeah, I
want to
try. Oh, I like playing this in VR though. I have to be honest. I like it. It's immersive. What is this?
Can you, Ginko, can I actually bring you?
Oh, I'm on it. Yes.
Come here, my queen. I'll bring you over here. Actually, I'll stop here though because it's not my thing.
I'm coming. What's this? Ooh, clothing. Ooh, clothing. Ooh, helmet. Whoa, Cherry is giving me tons of gifts because we're going to do a boss battle soon. Okay, let me equip the stuff Cherry gave me.
So much luck. We're gonna go and fight the end boss. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. Like the first one, actually.
Okay, I'm so ready. I got Cherry's loot. She gave me stuff, like good equipment, even a mace. And we're going to fight our first boss, right? My first boss, actually.
Yeah.
I think it's probably your 10th boss or 100th boss, I don't know.
So actually, I'm gonna drop something. You can grab this. You can actually...
Where?
You can use this to... Here, over here. Can you see it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Use this to summon it. I want to see what it looks like for you. Come, let's do this.
Okay, so in this game, you defeat bosses for skills.
Yeah, it's all like right. It's like a power skill, like a god skill you can use.
Okay,
like
I think I already have a power, right? You said with my B button, I can check this. I have no idea what it does though, but I think what is it? Power of Aiktir.
Are you with Aiktir still? Oh, I got bone mass. Aiktir actually gives you. That's actually this one we're going to defeat now. It gives more stamina, or like reduces stamina use, so you can use your stamina more.
Okay. All right. I activated. So I should offer item then.
Yeah, so you can you do that actually?
Let me
are?
Check.
Because you have to offer the things I gave you. You can put it on number.
Actually, I don't know if it will work. Let me see if can I just do it like this.
Let me know. No, no, you need to. Oh my god!
I don't know how to do it. Maybe Cherry can do it this time, and we'll just have to figure it out later.
Yeah, okay, that's okay. Cool. I actually just was wondering if you could do it. Yeah, it's okay. I can do it for us. I think he's quite strong. So
okay. Oh, let me just do the bow and arrow first, maybe?
Guess.
Oh, okay. Oops.
There it goes.
I am so not ready.
Behind you! Be careful!
Oh, my god!
So he has like a few attacks. So you need to dodge sometimes or run away from him.
Okay.
Oh my gosh, look at this.
Whoa, it's a deer!
Yeah.
Whoa!
Oh my gosh! Ah, okay. He hit me!
Yeah, let me go there. How do I block again? Using a shield.
Yeah.
Let me equip the spear.
Where is he going?
Let me try and throw the spear at him. I think that should work.
Oh my gosh. Ow.
Wait, where's my spear? Head.
You threw it.
I threw it. Where is
you
it?
Threw it. Oh, he's on fire. You did that.
Yeah.
Nice, guys.
I'm shooting it.
Nice, nice, nice.
With my
arrow. Really good job. Ow.
Are you carrying me?
I actually, I'm not even attacking him. You're doing all the
really?
All the good stuff.
So cool.
Yeah.
Does that help?
Be careful, guys. He's going to you. Be careful, guys.
Uh-oh. Let me run away.
Attack.
Okay, let me get the shield again. I want to just fight him with my hands now. Come on.
What is he doing though? Where is he jumping to?
Oh my gosh.
Oh, be careful.
Oh, I think I blocked it.
You did. Cass, you got
blocking,
it, girl.
Blocking. Okay, help me. Am I dying? No, I'm not.
No. Oh, nice.
Did we do it?
Yay!
Yes.
Yay!
First boss! Down!
Yeah!
Thank you, baby. That was so sweet.
Actually, you can grab it.
What?
You get the trophy.
That's the trophy thing from Sea Styles had in his house.
Yeah. So you get a trophy. And normally, come here.
Hey, I have a quest. The bird is back. Let me talk to him
fast. Talk to him.
Return to the sacrifice of stones with your forsaken trophy and offer it as a sacrifice. Okay.
So what he meant, over here, the sacrifice of stones are over here.
Oh.
So you sacrificed the head part, but you already did it, so you can just keep it as a trophy. And then you get the skill.
Ah, I already did it. Okay. I think we did a lot already today, right? I mean, we farmed, we built, we adventured.
we made a spear and lost it again as well.
Yeah. But we did a lot. We killed a boss, right? Was it a boss or a mini boss?
Yeah, it was a boss. It was a boss.
We killed a boss.
Like, this is the first
one. So cool. Okay. I think we should keep the rest for maybe a live stream or something, because I definitely want to jump back into this game. What do you think?
Yeah, I agree. Oh, you want to end it over there?
Yeah.
A nice view?
Yeah.
I'm coming.
Let's move to the outro then. Bye.
Bye everyone!
Okay, before we move to the outro, let me show you how to install the mod first. Thankfully, it is super easy. What you need is this link at nexusmods.com. I'll put the link below in the description, so just click that. Make sure you have an account here. If you don't, you have to register for an account. I have an account already, so I'm just going to log in. It should then bring you back to this page. If not, just click the link again in the description. Now scroll down, click on files here, and make sure you download this mod which includes the motion controls. Click on manual download here. And this mod requires this package as well, so click on it. Should open in a new tab. Let's download this first. Click on manual download here. It started downloading. Now go back to the previous page, because we also need to download the mod itself. Click on download here. So I'm using a free account, so I have to click on slow download. Once it's done downloading in Chrome, you can just click on this arrow, then show in folder. And it should bring you to the download folder. Mine is right here. Now we have two zip files, we have to unzip them. In Windows, you can just use a right click, then extract all. Click extract. It will show up in the same folder. Now the next one as well, extract all. Now we have two folders, right? So we have to actually install the mod in the game file. So let's open Steam. And to find the folder, you can go to Steam and then right click Valheim. Then manage, browse local files. It will open the folder where you installed your game. So we're going to copy the mod first, which is this one. The folder that's called VHVR. Now we're going to copy these two folders inside the game folder. So just drag and drop it like that. And replace the files if you get the pop-up. We're going to have to do the same thing with the other package that we downloaded, which is this one, the Denixon BEP InX pack. So what you have to do is go inside this folder, don't forget to do that, and then copy everything inside your game files folder. Replace again if you get the pop-up. Okay, now it's installed. We have a few last things to do. Go back to Steam, right-click Valheim, then click on Properties. And then in the general settings, make sure that you have this off. So use desktop game theater should be off like this. Now the mod is already installed, so you can just start a game. It will start in Steam VR as well. But now the only thing that you have to do in the game settings is to disable a couple of graphics settings, which are these ones. Just make sure that the settings looks like this. Now, if you have some more trouble, then definitely check out this webpage. It has an FAQ with some troubleshooting tips, but also settings and stuff that you can try out. I will put a link below. One more thing, now if you want to disable the mod without having to uninstall the whole mod, you can do that. Just go to Steam and then back to Browse Local Files. Then go into BEP InX, then config. Open up this file, this plugins Valheim VR mods.cfg. Right click it. And then you can open it with Notepad or something else that you use. I use Notepad++ for this. Then use Control F. And look for mod enabled. Find next. It's on line 62 right now. And just make this false. Type false here. Make sure to save it. File, save. If it's grayed out, then you saved it already. And that's it. Now you can play flat screen again. If you want to play VR again, just do the same thing. But then instead of false, make this true again. That's it, and now let's move on to my final thoughts and outro. So maybe you can tell already that Cherry and I adore these types of games, as you can just get really lost in exploring and building, and you can do everything together. It's just very addictive. So I was thrilled to see a VR mod with controller support come out, and I loved how immersive it felt. I mean, it's definitely not perfect yet. It takes time figuring out controls, and it doesn't seem like everything is working yet. For example, the HUD is small, so it's not easy reading everything. Scrolling in menus is hard right now, and in the video you could see I didn't know how to do certain things like offering an item for the boss. Currently, it's also hard to run and jump simultaneously, as both buttons are on the same controller. You can probably solve that yourself by remapping the controls. You know, having to figure out stuff yourself is usually the case with VR mods, and this mod is still only the first version with motion controller support, so I'm sure it will get better over time. As you could see in the video, I could do the most important things out of the box, so that's great already. If you can look through the other stuff, I would definitely recommend checking out this game in VR, as the core gameplay is just fun and VR makes it even more impressive. Keep in mind that the flat game is in early access, so the core game does have bugs and it's not well optimized, so it will be even more resource heavy if you want to play this in VR. Make sure your PC
can handle it, or that your stomach can handle it, and that you have strong VR legs so that you can just play through some frame drops. For my PC, it actually worked great and I never felt sick either. You can check out my specs in the description below. And thanks for watching. Let me know what you think about Valheim and if you are going to play it in VR or not. A special thanks go to all our champions, especially these patrons below. As always, VR on.